Have you been in a situation where you're driving in peak car traffic that's moving inch by inch on a flyover and your car is rolling backwards every time you try to move the car forward? By the end of this video, you will be able to precisely move your car up a slope without rolling back. It's lockdown here in Chennai, which is why I'm making this video in my house. However, I've parked the car on a slope, as you can tell from the way the car is rolling back. Before getting into the technique itself, there is something about the clutch that you should know in order to make use of these techniques. Make sure you are in a safe spot to try this. Pull the handbrake and shift the car in first gear. Then gradually release the clutch like how I am doing right now. When you are releasing the clutch, there will be a position where you feel the car is trying to move forward. There will also be a change in the engine sound and reduction in engine RPM. This position is called as the biting point. It is the point where the gear has just about been engaged. Your car will turn off if you release the clutch further. Pressing it further in will disengage the gear. Biting point varies from car to car, and it is important to find out where the biting point lies in your car. Now that you know what biting point means, let me show you how to drive the car on a slope, without the handbrake and with the handbrake. Moving your car up a slope without using the handbrake is advisable only on mild to moderate slopes. To do this, press and hold the brake pedal, then release the clutch till the biting point. You will feel the car trying to move forward. While holding the clutch at the biting point, take your foot off the brake. If it's a mild slope, your car will most likely stay at the same place without rolling back. Then press the accelerator pedal and the car will move forward. The usage of this technique also depends on the torque output of your engine. Engines with higher torque will handle steeper slopes without a fuss, especially diesel engines, as they produce more torque than petrol engines. Once you start using this technique regularly, you will be able to tell if a slope is too steep for your car. If the slope seems too steep, it is always better to use the handbrake. Here's how it's done. Pull up the handbrake, shift to the first gear, then release the clutch till the biting point. Then slightly press the accelerator. You will feel the car trying to move forward. At this point, release the handbrake. The car will most likely move forward, or it will stay there, but it will not roll back. As you move forward, press the accelerator further and release the clutch completely. This is a very safe technique, and it is better to stick to this technique when you don't feel confident enough about climbing up the slope ahead of you. I recommend that you practice these techniques regularly so that one day you will be able to handle slopes with ease. If this video helped you, let me know in the comment section. Also, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure to press that subscribe button, and I shall see you in my next video.